My name is Catherine or Kate. So today I'd like us to do a simple stitch. It's called single crochet stitch. So the materials we need are the yarn, a crochet hook, and I'm using a tape measure because I want to make a heart for a baby. So I'll measure our chain. So we start. Here is our yarn. We make a slip stitch. This is how we make a slip stitch. A slip knot, I mean. So we start chaining. You can count or measure, but I usually measure. So this is how you make a chain. So I want to make a chain of 6 inches.
Misha, ready, Misha.
So we measure using our tape measure. It's longer than the 6 inches that I want, so I reduce. It's still longer. So we continue. When you reach at the end of the chain, of your desired stitches of length, so now we start working on the other side. So here is our chain, that's how it is. So we are going to skip the first stitch. This is our first stitch. We go to the second. So you are going to put your crochet hook on that stitch. You take up yarn that way, you yarn over, you go through the two stitches. You do the same for the next stitch, go through the stitch, take up yarn, go through the two stitches. Again, you go through the stitch, take up yarn, yarn over, go through the two stitches. So you are going to continue that way, going through the stitch, take up yarn, yarn over, and go through the two. So let's meet at the end to show you how we finished the second row. So here we are at the end of the chain. It's our last stitch. So you go through just like you did with the others. Pull up our yarn. So now at the end of the chain, when you've already done the last stitch and you want to turn your work, you chain one and then turn. Once you turn, we are going to skip the chain stitch. this one. We're going to skip this one, we'll go through this one. And the single crochet that I want us to do is single ribbed. So when you look at this, on top of this, we have two loops. We have the outer and we have the inner. So we can go through the outer or the inner or under the two. So for today, we are going through the outer one. When you look at this, we have this, and then there is the under. We go through the two. So today we are going through this one. Now, this is how it goes. You go that way. Take up yarn. Go through the two. Again. On the outer, go through, take up yarn, and go through the two loops. We are going to continue this way, going through the outer stitch or the outer loop, take up yarn, and go through the two stitches. So we meet at the end, show how to finish, and start the fourth row. The third. So this is how we finish. To the last loop. We go through, take up yarn, go through the two. And now for it to be a stitch at the end, you're going through the very last two loops. We go through the two of them. Take up yarn and go through. So we are going to chain one and turn our work. And we are going to do just as we did with the previous row. You skip the first stitch, go through the second, the outer loop, take up yarn, go through the two. You go through the loop, take up yarn, go through the two stitches. This is all we are going to do for the entire work. We are going to do this. At the end of this row, you're going to realize that there is a pattern that is appearing that is ribbed.
Daddy.
It looks like ridges.
Daddy.
We are finishing this row and I want us to look at the pattern, how the pattern is forming,
Daddy.
And the Daddy. Forming of the ribs.
Daddy.
So when you look at it, this is how it is forming. This is how it is forming. It's easily felt. By look, you can see, and even by touching, you can feel the ribs. They are like ridges. They are like foldings. That's how they are. So thank you for viewing this. See you next in the next tutorial. Goodbye.